seconds to go. Start. The stance of the bank that these representations were not in response to the notice under section 13(2) dated 1st August 2016 was rejected as the borrower through representations had pleaded difficulties being faced by it in repaying the loan installments and sought extension of moratorium more time for repayment. The High Court held that it was not necessary for the borrower to specifically mention that the representations were in response to the notice under section 13(2) of the SARFAESI Act. Further, relying upon the decision of the Bombay High Court in Blue Coast Hotels Limited versus IFCI Limited and another, which decision on challenge became the subject matter of the appeal and decision of this court in ITC Limited Supra, the High Court held that there is no specific provision or mandate under Section 13(3)(a) of the SARFAESI Act that the representation of the borrower to the demand notice under Section 13(2) should be filed within a period of 60 days from the date of notice. The impugned judgment also refers to the letter dated 7th November 2016 to observe that the chief manager of the bank had recommended deferring of action under the SARFAESI Act with the intent that the unit running in the subject property should be granted benefit of deferment of action. The bank had proceeded to issue possession notice on 3rd March 2017 under section 13(4) of the SARFAESI Act long after receipt of the representations dated 1st 6th November 2016 but without making any reference to the aforesaid representation. Accordingly, on the first point, the High Court concluded that there had been a violation by the bank of its mandatory statutory duty under Section 13(3)(a) of the SARFAESI Act. On the second question, reference was made to Section 17(1) of the SARFAESI Act, which deals with the right of appeal by a party aggrieved by the measures referred to in subsection 4 to section 13. Relying on the decision of this court in Authorized Officer, Indian Overseas Bank and another versus Ashok Sawmill, it was held that the series of steps from the date of action by the secured creditor under section 13(2) of the SARFAESI Act up to the date of auction and sale confirmation can be challenged by the borrower when it challenges the measures referred to in the subsection 4 to section 13 under section 17 of the SARFAESI Act. In this view of the matter, the High Court with respect to the second issue held that though the OA was filed on 1st October 2018, the borrower can challenge the possession notice issued on 3rd March 2017, taking of symbolic possession, taking of physical possession in May 2017, the sale notice issued on 2nd July 2018, and the sale certificate dated 27 September 2018 as they all form part of the same cause of action. Consequently, it was observed that challenge to the actions measures prior to 2nd July 2018 would not be barred by limitation. In view of the factual matrix of the present case, which has been set out in detail above, and the aspect of waiver and estoppel discussed subsequently, it is not necessary for us to examine the question of violation of Section 13(3)(a) of the Surfacey Act, and also whether the cause of action from the date of issue of notice under Section 13(2) of the Surfacey Act till the issuance of the sale certificate is a continuing cause of action. Suffice it would be to observe that in the case of ITC Limited Supra, this court, in spite of holding that there was violation of Section 13(3)(a) of the Surfacey Act, and consequently the notice of possession under Section 13(4) was vitiated, had allowed the appeal in view of the attendant circumstances set out in subparagraphs of paragraph 30 on the ground that the debtor post of the notice under Section 13(4) of the Surfacey Act had given proposals with assurances, letter of undertaking for repayment of the mortgage debt pursuant to which time was granted, and consequently the sale notice was deferred. Only when payments were not made as promised, that the creditor had proceeded to recover the dues. Stop.